Hi there. My name is Andy Heath. I'm the co-director of Under Western Skies. And this is the first in some instructional videos that I'm going to post up on Facebook and eventually on the website as well. Today, we're going to show you one of the many skills that you guys can learn over the course of the summer. I like to call it busting a coal. And you might have seen this on TV or somewhere else, but this is actually starting a fire with what's called a bow drill, which is using friction to create enough heat with the wood to produce a smoldering ember. When we produce the ember, it's actually going to go into a small, what we like to call a nest, of flammable material that we're going to blow into a flame. Now, the most important thing about making your nest, obviously, is to get it in a nice little nest shape so you've got a nice open bowl. But you want to use what we like to call fines, which are really fine material that you're going to break loose from some of this larger stuff. So you almost wind up with kind of a powdery, dry, super flammable material that you're going to put into the middle of your nest. And this gives a really nice place to put your ember so it will land in some really easily burnable material. So we're looking for really fine material like that. And it will actually go right into the center of your nest. Make that nice and neat. Tuck it in. Oh yeah. Okay, so that part out of the way, we'll set this nest aside. Now we'll get ready to actually set ourselves up here to bust a coal. Now, I like to have something to catch the ember. So basically, what's going to happen is you have three major parts. You have the bow, the fireboard, and the spindle. And as you can see by this spindle, this one's been used quite a bit. But this bottom burnt part is the part that's going to fit into the bottom of the fireboard and spin as we're pushing down on it and turning it with the bow to create the pressure and the friction to make the ember. So when you're first starting off, most important thing is patience. This is it's a difficult process. It takes a little while to get to learn it, but you will learn it. You just have to keep going and keep going and keep going and keep going. So the most important thing I would say about this whole deal is probably how you're situated, how your body is set up, how you're, how would I word that? Your body stance probably makes it a little easier just to show you. So with your fireboard on the ground here, it's placed right over top of your piece of leather that's going to catch your ember on the other side. And if you notice, in the bottom of the fireboard, there's a little notch. That notch is what allows the ember, which is going to be created inside this socket, to fall down to below where we can catch it. So we're going to place our fireboard top of our leather. Foot on top of the fireboard to hold it steady. Now we've turned the bow into the spindle. So the easiest way to do this is to flex your bow a little bit. The spindle comes in and it spins around once. So now we've got this nice, neat little loop around the spindle. And that holds the spindle tight. Foot on the fireboard. Spindle in the hole. Okay? Now if you notice, top part here is a little pointy, sharp, whatever you want to call it. We're going to use our top socket, which is actually a piece of harder wood. The wood that we're using for the fireboard and the spindle are cottonwood, which is a pretty soft wood. This is actually a piece of mountain mahogany. It's very, very resilient, very hard wood. So actually, we can push down on this really hard to make a bunch of friction on the bottom. So with that, the top socket, you'll notice a little hole right there, fits right on top of the spindle. And this top socket's pretty nice, actually. It's got a nice rounded top to it, so it's easy to get your hand on it. Now, if you notice how my body's positioned, I've got my knee way out behind me, okay? I've got my foot on the fireboard, and I'm bracing my arm and my hand up against my shin, okay? I'm laying all my body weight on this part of my thigh. So basically, this allows me a lot of weight. So I'm shifting my body weight forward, which allows me to push down on this spindle into the bottom socket here and make a lot of heat and a lot of pressure. Now, when you're first starting, go slow. Like I said, this is a process, takes a little while to learn. Once you get the motion down, now notice, as I'm moving the bow here, I'm trying to keep it in a relatively flat plane. If you're going like this, or you're pushing it way up, you're gonna drag the back of the bow or the tip of the bow in the dirt. And it also gets this piece of twine that's wrapped around the spindle to move up and down the spindle. So you're kind of fighting it up and down and up and down the whole time. So try to keep your bow real.
Spanish bang there.
Ember, take our nest. There's plenty of time here, so you don't want to rush it. Drop our ember into our nest. Curl our nest around it. Now we're going to see if we can blow it into some flame.